In this video, we want to review the different types of price bars within Track and Trade. I'm doing this demonstration in the Forex version of Track and Trade, but these features are exactly the same whether using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. Now you'll notice the price bars that we're looking at currently are red, yellow, and green, and that's because this demonstration is being done using the bulls and bears, the infamous bulls and bears tool, which changes the price bars from red, yellow, and green, indicating whether the market is neutral, bullish, or bearish. And so what we want to do is go back and show you how to get back to the traditional color. Of course, to do that, we just simply have to turn off the bulls and bears, and we can do that by removing that color selection here. And this is taking us back to the traditional color set. Now, inside of Track and Trade, we have a number of different price bars. And if we have the preferences set, by simply clicking on the chart, it's going to bring up the chart preferences. Now, there's several ways that we can obtain access to changing price bars. First of all, you'll notice that they're right here in the settings for daily charts. And we come in here and we can drop this down and we can have the open, high, low, close. We can have a high, low, close bar. We can have a close bar. We can have the open bar. We can have a candlestick style chart, and we can have none. We can have no chart at all if you would prefer. So if we go back to the open, high, low, close bar, you'll notice that what we do is we can also come over here and we can right click on the chart, and we're going to also have access to these same controls. So we can say price bar type, open, high, low, close, close, open, candle, and none. So these are accessible by right clicking on the chart as well. Let me also show you, while we're in here, let me show you a feature that we have for the candlesticks. And you'll notice that we also have what we call the proportional width price bars. And you'll see that the price bars are relatively thick in this case. If we want to turn that off, we can simply come down here and turn off proportional width. And you'll notice that it kind of simplifies the price bars, makes them not quite so thick on the screen. It's more noticeable when we zoom in a little bit. We come in and turn on proportional width. You can see the difference, depending on which way you like to view those. And then we're going to come down here to, we're going to slide down through the preferences tab, and we're going to come all the way down to price bar preferences. And we can come in and we can make different changes to the different colors of the different price bars through this control panel here. You'll notice that we can have close higher bars can be long green or whatever color we would prefer. Close lower is red. This is very traditional colors that are set as the defaults. And no change is going to be white. We can show price bar text here by simply turning this on and off. You'll notice up in the left-hand corner, this is the cursor text that's up here. We can also fill all the candles if we'd like. And you'll notice that we have open body candles at this point. If we'd like to see those filled, we can simply click this box here and it's going to fill those. The last thing that I would like to show you regarding different price bars is the Heiken-Ashi. Heiken-Ashi is a mathematical formula that averages the price bars. So to example that, it's easier to see that. I'm going to come in and change it back to open, high, low, close. And I'm going to turn back on the proportional width. And if you look at the price bars, you'll notice that they are traditional price bars set in this way, in this manner. If we slide back up here under the price bars, you'll notice that we are currently working on the open, high, low, close bar style. And that's this chart that's selected. If we click right here, Heiken-Ashi, you'll notice that we come up with a warning that says the Heiken-Ashi price bars are calculated differently than regular price bars. If you'd like to know more information about how they're calculated, you can click here and it'll give you more information. But what we're doing is we're basically averaging out the price bars, and you'll notice the difference here, the way they look. We also have a quick button bar right here, a little button up here that says HA. This is to toggle the Heiken-Ashi back on and off. And so you can see how it changes the difference back and forth between those two settings. So that's the different types of price bars and the Heiken-Ashi price bar feature within Track and Trade.